Mary said, My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour, because the Lord has looked on his lowly handmaid. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brethren, on this Saturday memorial of our blessed day, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting.
Amen.
Peace.
John came to Jesus, saying, "Why do we and the Pharisees fast, but your disciples do not fast?" And Jesus said to them, "Can the wedding guests mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them? The days will come when the bridegroom is taken away from them, and then they will fast. And no one puts a piece of unshrunk cloth on an old garment, for the patch tears away from the garment, and a worse tear is made. Neither is new wine put into old wineskins. If it is, the skins burst, and the wine is spilled, and the skins are destroyed. But new wine is put into fresh wineskins, and so both are preserved." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There's a poetic balance in the fact that the first reading is a prophecy of peace coming again to Israel. They will plant their vines, and our Lord speaks of new wine going into fresh wineskins, the fruit of the vine. Perhaps it's a nice image of the promise of the old covenant and the promise fulfilled of the new. Thinking about it, new wine is still fermenting, and so it still produces gas, which means that it would expand in an old wineskin and cause it to tear, losing both the skin and the wine. Whereas a new wineskin has a bit of give and allows for the natural fermentation of the new wine as it matures in the skin. And so new wine, new skins seem sensible. It's nice to think of this image of the vessel, especially as we commemorate our Blessed Lady on this Saturday Memoria in her honour. Because she is the singular vessel of devotion, the vessel of honour, as we call her in her liturgy. She is the vessel prepared to receive Christ, who is our new wine. The gifts of Christ in us are to increase, to ferment within us. We have been made new wineskins. We have been renewed by our baptism, who were made capable of receiving God and his grace. Our Lady is the vessel prepared before all time to be full of grace. We must ask her, as the mediatrix and dispenser of all grace, to help us become good vessels. After all, as St. Paul says, we hold a treasure, but in basic earthenware vessels. Treasure more priceless than gold, but we are frail vessels. Our Lady is the strong vessel, but of course, as mediatrix, she reminds us that her vessel is to be poured out. We do not contain God merely for ourselves. We are called to be vessels transmitting God's grace to others. Our Lady is a vessel, and she would be poured out as what she contained was given to the whole world, our Blessed Lord himself. This weekend, as public mass resumes, the people of God once again will be able to receive our Lord in Holy Communion. They will be able to be vessels of God, tabernacles, just as Our Lady was. And how our Lord must be longing to come to his vessels and to dwell with his people. Today, between 10 and 1, we have an opportunity in our parishes to come to confession, to be the best possible vessel in order to hold the Lord of all. Let us remember then, too, to imitate our Blessed Lady, we might be vessels into which God is poured and out of which we may pour him to others for benediction on the whole world. Let us pray then that the grace of God, like the fermenting new wine, will also increase within us. We have been made capable. coming week, that they may imitate her in her virtues. O Mary, conceived without sin, pray for us as well as your city. Amen. My sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty.
In the wilderness of sacrifice, your hands, the praise of the Lord of his name, for our good and the cause of the Church.
May the offerings your people make in commemoration of Blessed Mary be acceptable to you, O Lord, for by her virginity she pleased you, and in humility conceived your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns forever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to our sins, done great things, and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty, and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs, in one chorus of exultant praise, as we acclaim. Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, Lenis cum Caeli et Terra, Gloria Tua, Hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus qui venit, in nomine Domini, Hosanna in excelsis. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and we have created rightly gives you praise, that through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather the people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to his setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, chalice of his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory."
Peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever.
Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Treasured on these words, reflected on them in her heart.
Most sacred heart of Jesus.